Welcome, everybody. My name is Irene. I am your scientific popularizer for the Rolli Palaces today. And I am joyed to welcome you in this marvelous palace, Tobia Pallavicino Palace, which today houses the Chamber of Commerce of Genoa. The original nucleus of this building is well documented in 8 engravings by Rubens in the opening of his book on the modern palaces of Genoa, which he published in Antwerp in 1622. During the beginning of the 18th century, this building underwent at least 2 major alterations, respectively over elevation and extension. The elements that marks this renovating intervention are the marble balcony in correspondence of the noble floor and the decoration that characterized the over elevated areas, which are made by lime plasters for the structural element and with the stucco for the decorative elements such as medallions, friezes and cornices. Another process of renovation took place during the mid 18th century, and it dealt with the construction of a courtyard towards south and also the new fresco facade facing as well south towards Piazza del Ferro. After this newly finished renovation, we can see that the palace is completely different, unrecognizable, corresponding with its original nucleus. And this was because there was a change in ownership, different changes in ownership of this palace. We are now inside these beautiful spaces adorned by these original pieces of art. And here I would like to tell you the story about the person who wanted this palace to be built. I'm talking about Tobia Pallavicino, who was one of the first Genoese aristocrats in the 16th century, and also the head of an international commercial and economic organization. In fact, Tobia, between 1566 and 1578, he led a policy of monopoly in the Western markets for the import of the alum of Tolfa, a precious material useful for dye color on fabrics. This monopoly was also possible and indeed favored by the Ottoman mediation species and materials market on the east. This made native production even more fierce and competitive. So this richness allowed Tobia to purchase this lot of land and build this wonderful palace at the end of the 16th century. It was also very close to Il Bergamasco, who was an intellectual and an artist, very famous in Genoa, and who was ushered into history by Genoese clientele. Tobia entrusted him not only for the design of this building, but also for the interior decoration. He took care of his education by financing him his journey to Rome to discover the innovation in the artistic panorama. Tobia was a patronage and a lover of art, and he wanted to surround himself by beautiful pieces of art, as we can see in this marvelous atrium. From this wonderful atrium with 3 arches, we see this wonderful staircase, which seems symmetry with 2 opposite ramps. But one of these 2 ramps is actually false. This one that is surmounted by the original wooden door is actually closed. This was a design from the Bergamasco, which wanted to give the atrium a nicely perspective, which will be symmetric. And so this kind of design remained not only inside a characteristic of this building, but also was taken as model for other buildings in Genoa. In order to appreciate these wonderful frescoes, we see up there the cycle of Apollo, and everywhere there are decorations always by the Bergamasco. This is an incredible, this is a magic place. We are entering now in the main floor, the noble floor, which is characterized by incredible decoration of writing stuccos and relief decorations, as well as the marvelous frescoes by the Bergamasco, where we can find, in fact, here, up here, in the central octagon of the vault, Apollo with three muses, surrounded by four other medallions depicting musicians, which are probably muses as well. The cycle of Apollo was pretty loved by the master of the house, because Tobia Pallavicino was a man who loved art, science and culture, and wanted to surround himself by wonderful pieces of art, as well as Apollo wanted to surround himself by the gods who protected all artistic expressions. Among the major changes due to the extension of the building wanted by Carrega family in the mid-18th century is included this wonderful room. It is probably the one of the most important rooms of this palace, because it's one of the dazzling examples of the Genoese Rococo. It was completely designed and created by Lorenzo de Ferrari, who was the son of Gregorio de Ferrari and the grandson of the renowned Domenico Piola. De Ferrari was engaged in the decoration and the design of this room and other little salons of this area of the building for many years, at the head of a very big group of expert cooperators. In this room, as we can see, refined stuccos decoration are incredible, as we can see the putties or the caryatides, other pilasters, and the plant decoration of the portals are incredible. These stuccos framed as well the frescoes also by De Ferrari himself, which depict the cycle of a famous Trojan hero, Aeneas. We can find him, we can see him depicted there through Jupiter and Venus, because Jupiter is asking for Jupiter to save Aeneas from the wrath of Juno. On the lunette, on the other side, on the left side, we can see Aeneas taking a branch of the sacred tree. On the opposite lunette, we can find the boat of Aeneas drained by Neptune. All this cycle is framed and enriched by the golden stuccos. And this affection for Aeneas is linked to the patronage, but also to the Genoese history, because the adventure of Aeneas, his values, his strength, remembers and evokes in the Genoese people a more recent adventure of a fellow citizen, the hero of the two worlds, Christopher Columbus.